Hello and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will talk about RL circuit and RC circuit and their time constants. From where these time constants come from and what is the significance of these time constants. So this we will discuss in this video, and in the next video, we will derive the equation of currents for these two circuits. So let's get started. So the first circuit is this circuit, which is called RL circuit because we have a resistor and an inductor. So the value is 2 ohm for resistor, 10 henries for inductor, and we have applied 10 volts. So when we close this switch, initially there is no current because inductor stores the uses the current to store the energy. But slowly this current starts to build up and then it reaches a maximum value. So for this kind of circuit, the maximum value of the current which can ever pass through this circuit is the current which is 10 divided by 2, this resistor. So this is 5 amperes. So this is the maximum value of current which this circuit can ever pass. On the capacitor circuit, RC circuit, it happens in the opposite way. So when we close the switch, initially all the current passes through the capacitor, just like a short circuit. Then this capacitor starts to charge and the current starts to drop and it reaches a value which is very close to zero. So this is what happens here. And now these are the graphs and these are the equations. Using this equation, you can find the value of current at any time. So on this graph, time is on the x-axis and current is on the y-axis, and this is the maximum value for capacitor circuit and this is the maximum value of the inductor circuit. So this is the brief introduction of what is on this whiteboard at the moment. And now let's talk about the time constant. So time constant of a decaying parameter, any parameter, it could be current, it could be voltage. Currently we are using current. So time constant for a decreasing parameter is the time at which the time taken by the parameter to reach 37% of its maximum value. So we are looking for a 63% drop. So if this is the maximum value, you can say 1 or 100%. So this is the 63% drop of this value. So that is the time taken for this is called time constant. So if you measure this time in seconds, so that will be time constant. Similarly, for a rising graph, the time constant is the time taken to achieve the 63% of its maximum value. So this is 0.63. So 0.63 of the I maximum value. So what is the time taken? So if you drop a perpendicular and you measure this time in seconds, let's say. So this is one way of measuring the time constant. If you have this graph, so you can just actually physically take this on a scale, and then 63% of that scale, draw perpendicular on this graph, then draw perpendicular on x-axis and calculate the time on here. So this is a simple way of using the graph to find the time constant. But what is this time constant? And we know when you normally use the questions of these type of questions, you use a time constant of L divided by R. This is for LR type of circuits. These type of circuits, we use time constants, and this is denoted by normally tau. And for these type of circuits, we use time constants, which is equal to RC. R is the resistor, C is the capacitor value, capacitance value. So these are the formulas. So how we reach on these formulas? Why we use these formulas for time constant? So this is what we are talking about in this video. So now, one step back, what is this 0.37? 0.37 is actually 1 divided by E. And 1 divided by E is the base of the nature logarithm. So 1 divided by E, which is 2.78 something, if you divide it, you will get this 0.37 value. So this is 1 divided by E, and similarly, this 0.63 is basically 1 minus 1 divided by E. Or in other ways, you can say 1 minus 0.37, so which is 63%, or 0.63. So basically there is only one factor, which is 1 divided by E. Because if it's rising, we just subtract it from 1. If it's decreasing, we take this as it is. So how we got this as a value of L divided by R? Because this is very important. If we know L divided by R, so we have L and R mentioned here. So we can straight away tell the time constant of this circuit. And this gives us a very important information, which I will describe later. But first, from where we get these values? So in order to understand this, we have to have a look at these equations, which we will be driving. And we will actually see how we reach here. But in this video, I just want to explain how we get this, why this circuit will reach at this value, and why, how we can get these values from these equations. So now, first we look at this equation. So if you look at this equation, this is the value of the maximum, and this is the factor which we are looking for. So this is the rising factor. We want this factor equal to this thing, 1 minus 1 divided by E. So if you look here, and if you look here, this is e raised to the power minus r divided by l into t. So now imagine what value of t, if I put here, I get e raised to the power minus 1 only. Obviously the value of t should be the reciprocal of this r divided by l, which is l divided by r. If I put this value for t, for time, in this equation, we will get 1 minus e raised to the power minus 1, which is this factor, because e raised to the power minus 1 means 1 divided by e. So therefore, this is the time constant of a RL circuit. Because if I put this for time, I will get I maximum multiplied by 0.63. This value will make this part, this factor, 0.63. So therefore, this is the time constant of any RL circuit. Similarly, for RC circuit, what value of T if I put here, which will make this thing as 1 divided by E? So the value of T should be RC. If I put RC for T here, these two RC will be cancelled out, and e raised to the power minus 1 will there, which is 1 divided by e. So therefore, RC is the time constant of a RC type of circuit in which we have a resistor and a capacitor. So these are the time constants. Now, the next thing is, in most of the graphs, you will see that instead of time, you will see 1 tau, 2 tau, 3 tau, 4 tau and 5 tau. Tau is time constant. So sometimes these graphs, instead of time, they denote this thing. And why is so? Because generally it is accepted that after 5 time constants, once the 5 time constants have been elapsed, the system will reach its final value or the steady state value, which will stay there. So after 5 time constants, the capacitor circuit will reach its minimum current, and after 5 time constants, the inductor circuit will also reach its maximum value, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 time constants. So whatever is the value of the time constant, let's take this example. The time constant of this circuit is L divided by R, which is 10 divided by 2, which is 5 seconds. So it means that after 25 seconds, this circuit will reach its maximum current value. This is very significant, because just by looking at this circuit, you can straight away tell that when this circuit will reach its maximum current. By looking at this diagram only, if you know that the time constant is of this circuit is always RC, so by looking at R and C value, you can straight away tell that let's say 15 divided 2 multiplied by 3 is 6. 6 seconds is the time constant, so 5 time constants means 30 seconds. So after 30 seconds, this circuit will reach its value. So this is the importance of time constant. Once you know how we reach this. So in this video, I only explained the end result, the end of the equation. From this equation, you can see that we can get the time constant values, these values. We normally use these values without thinking from where these values are coming from. So this is the explanation of this time constant. And in the next video, we will actually derive these two equations. So really see that how we reach there. So thanks for watching and see you in the next video.